Good morning, students. Today I will explain you object-oriented programming concepts. Last day we have done procedural programming concepts and structural programming concepts. Today I will explain you about the object-oriented programming concepts. What is object-oriented programming? Last day I explained you that what is the main limitation of procedural programming concept? That it focuses on the procedure, not on the data. To remove that limitation, object-oriented programming, it focuses mainly on the object, and procedure will give the second attention. So this approach will give the data prime consideration. Okay, so the problem will give in terms of objects, not in the terms of procedure. Okay, so the main basic concept is moving around the object. So what is object? First, you should understand this. Object is an identifiable entity. It has particular characteristics and particular behavior. So, what is the main concept of object? It has a particular state, it will display some behavior, and it has unique identity. Like you all. You all means each of you are a particular object. You all may be in your particular state. Maybe you are standing, maybe you are sitting, maybe you are reading. Then you can display your behavior. Display your behavior means sometime you can be happy, sometime you can be sad. And you all have your unique identity, like you all got your unique ID in your ID card. In the same way, each and every object has its own identity. If we will take another example of orange. Orange is an object. What are its characteristics? It is spherical in shape. Its color is orange. And what is its behavior? It is juicy and it tastes sweet, sir. So in this way, you can say that in this world, each and every object has its own identity. It has its own state and it can display some behavior. Next is class. This class and object, they both are related to each other. Because class is a group of object. Group of object, but which type of object? Class is a group of object, which share common properties and relationships. Like you all are studying in class 9. In which class? Class 9. You all are sharing some common properties because you all have the same syllabus. That's why you are grouping in the same class, class 9. Okay. And it bounds member data and methods. Member data means you all are, each and every students are the data. Each of you are the objects which grouped together in a class 9. Okay, and you all are relevant to one task. Which task? Because you all have to study according to class 9 syllabus. Okay, I think you understood about the concept of class and object and how these two terms are related to each other. Object is an particular entity of the class and class is the group of object. Another example we can take like the bird. Bird is a class. But its different objects can be parrot, crow, sparrow and peacock. these can be the different objects of class. But some basic concepts of object-oriented programming on which our object-oriented programming is based, that are abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism. Now, one by one, I will explain you about these concepts. First of all, about the abstraction. Abstraction means only to show the essential feature which is necessary for you. Other parts will be hidden. For example, if you want to on the switch, we will only press the required switch, okay? But we don't know about the internal circuit which is hidden behind the switchboard. So we will deal only with the switches. This is the example of abstraction. In the capsule, only we can intake the capsule. But what is hidden inside the capsule, we don't know about that. Which medicine is hidden inside it, we don't know about it. Next topic is encapsulation. Encapsulation means wrapping up of data and its associated function into a single unit. Which single unit? Class. Okay. So data and functions, these two are wrapped inside the class. This is known as encapsulation. One real world example we can give, like house. House is a class and its data member can be bed, sofa, television, fridge, and its associated function can be sleeping. Means you are sleeping on bed, you are cooking. So these all are the functions which we are doing inside the house. So our data members and associated functions, these both are encapsulated inside the class house. A better example is walnut. Inside the walnut shell, inner part is hidden and safe. Okay. Next OOPS concept is inheritance. It refers to the capability of one class of things to inherit the properties from another class. Like a child, it can inherit the properties from his parents. Okay. So in this example, child is known as the subclass and parent is known as the base class. Means subclass will inherit the properties from its base class. This property is known as inheritance. Okay. In this way, one class can inherit the properties from another class. That we will see later in next chapters. Next concept is polymorphism. What is polymorphism? It is the concept through which a message or data can be processed in more than one form. Same message, but it can be processed in different forms. For example, you are a boy. You are a boy, and sometime you can be a student, next time you can be a player. So in this way, same child can behave in different form. This is known as polymorphism. Okay. So these are the basic concepts of polymorphism. I think in this way your concepts about the object-oriented programming will be clear, and read the chapter thoroughly and see the presentation which I am sending you along with this recording. Thank you.